All right. Well, I'm really excited to just kind of dive right into this thing. I have never played with a C64 before, so I'm gonna switch cams. We're gonna do a big cam with the unboxing. I'll talk about it best I can. I've never played with one of these things, and what possessed me to buy this is I have impulse control issues. I think that's it. I think that's the main gist of it. So I'm gonna switch cams really quick. All right. So you can see this thing in front of me. There's my phone, keyboard. See, this is my tiny little desk. When people ask like for Destiny, like this is my mouse pad. I don't have a lot of space, so that's why I'm shit. It's definitely not other things. I looked right at the camera right there, and nobody saw it because I only have one camera on. Anyway. I also have Mickey Mouse pants and a Godzilla shirt on. Close my phone. All right, let's get to unboxing this thing. So, it doesn't have. Oh, there we go. Yeah, there's a clear rip in the plastic or seal in the plastic. Oh, that's not. Okay, well, that's just gonna be a one and done use anyway. Let's get through this bitch. It's very big. I'll tilt that camera up so you can see the size of this thing. Okay. Yeah, there's my Streamlabs. You can see that. Back to this. Okay. So, anything I gotta cut? No, no. Looks. Oh, right there, right there. Got some scissors right in here. No. I don't know where my scissors went. Of course, I don't know where my scissors went. I got a pen. There's always something. Every time I do anything, there's always something. Losing my scissors would definitely be the thing. Okay. All right. I'll keep adjusting the camera. This thing's really huge. So as I'm getting through this box, just bear with me as I'm kind of adjusting where I have things. It's hitting the camera stand. All right. So here is the C64 open out of the box. Well, this thing's pretty freaking big. I know that this is the joystick, which is the thing I actually am most excited about. It uses like a micro switch inside, so it's actually really. Oh yeah, listen to that. You hear that here? Put it right in front of the mic. Okay, so that's cool. There's the joystick. That's gonna be important when we go to play this. This is probably the power cable. If I had to guess, yeah, looks like it. A USB AC adapter. Plastic can go over there. That's the USB cable. Sure is. Sure is. That's good because I didn't want to have to dig one of those out too. Nobody wants to go have to hunt down a USB cable midway through. All right. I got an open plug right there behind me. So I've like I mentioned. Oh, this is not a particularly long cable. That might be a problem. But it's a mic. I can. Yeah, I'll make it work. Whatever. I will make it work. I don't know exactly how. Leave that cable right over there for now. But I'll make it work. The HDMI cable. Kind of an important one. Let's get that out too. We gotta get. We're skipping all the good stuff. We're getting to the good stuff last. That's what we're doing. So, I wanna check out the manual. I'm gonna leave this out because I genuinely have no idea what I'm doing with this thing. It's a gaming system. People have played on this. I should be able to figure it out. But this is before my time. I'm old, but this is still before my time. I'm gonna have some easy problems figuring out how to play these games, I'm guessing. Or they're all really, maybe they're super self-explanatory. Nice little manual. Nothing crazy. I'll just set that right over here. HDMI cable right over here. Alright, here's the beast. Here's the thing. Oh, it's well packaged. I love this dark gray plastic. This is very old style. Alright, so power button right there, 3 USB ports, power USB and HDMI on the back. You can plug in ROMs and things. I put some on a flash drive of a couple games I've heard were good on this system, but yeah, we'll see how it is. There's all sorts of symbols on this keyboard, like things I've never seen before. I don't know. But yeah. All right. So I'd say it's stored well in this box. I like it quite a bit. This is probably going to be the one and only time. Look at this compared to my keyboard. Hold on. I'll move the box. Let me move the box out of the way and we'll get to the sizing of this thing. That's why I wanted the second keyboard. That's why I wanted to do a little bit of an off normal stream just to show this thing off. Okay. So here this beast is. Can I just turn this? And just turn it. Here's my Godzilla shirt. Anyway. Here is my normal keyboard. It's obviously on the tray below it. And here's this thing. This thing is wider, significantly fatter than my little keypadless keyboard. Anyway, okay. So we're gonna mess with this a little bit more. All right, so there it is. Let's see if I can get the power cable up to it from where I have this plugged in. Feels like I can. Okay. Get that HDMI cable set up. So I'll give it, this thing is neat. It appears neat. My headphones have continually hit my thing, so I keep losing my music. I shouldn't just keep calling it neat. I mean, that's not the scientific term for what it is. But it is neat. It's very neat. All right, I'm gonna plug this in. Plastic's not my favorite, but it's not the worst either. And again, I've never handled an original, so I don't really know how wildly different that's going to be. Let me switch this over to HDMI. I'm going to plug this in on the side too. I'll plug it in the back, actually. Joystick looks like it has a decently long cable. 4 feet? 5 feet? I don't know. I am really bad at judging that, so. Oh, Mr. Hawks, thanks for the follow. Sorry I didn't say anything. I don't have alerts on this picture, weirdly enough. Okay. So, yes. This thing is it's a thick boy. Alright, let's turn it on. Let me make sure my... All right, let me switch over here. Okay. Get my little logo going. All right, and my video capture. Come on, turn on. Yeah, I've never played with one of these things. So. What you doing there? Hmm. My Elgato is not kicking on. Come on. There we go. Okay. Yeah, because I kind of want to show this thing off. Like, not just my face. Alright. So, yes, English. I'm just going to assume it's return. This is so weird, just feeling a keyboard. Okay, it's not that. What do I want to press here? Restore? What the? Alright, if I get stumped by this very first thing, I think that's really a bad sign. Can I just go back then? It's... Yeah, it's on English. That's what I want. Okay, so... Just the one let me out then. Well, okay. Cool, that was fun. Which button gets me over there? Okay. I'm genuinely upset with this. Oh, thank you. I disagree firmly, but I appreciate it. Alright. The fourth button? Oh, that could... Okay, sorry. Here, hold on. Let me... I'm going to turn off... I got to turn off my banners real quick so you can see what that was. All right, I'm just going to blind all those. All right. Down in the bottom corner, you see how there's four little buttons? On this, there are four little buttons, and that one was the back button right there. So this, to agree with this, I'm going to press this first little button right here. Right? Don't you dare fucking... It worked on the last thing. Why would this not work now? I'm in North America. Give me 60 hertz. Okay, now return works. Press A to accept. Is that supposed to be A? Does this work for A too? Ooh, they both work. Okay. I'm gonna click my banners back on. Yeah, this thing is insane size-wise. And I appreciate your name, Lord of All Creation. You're not sweatpants boy, whatever you were on Mixer. All right. So I dare going into Classic? I feel like this is a bad idea. Cause I'm not gonna know what I'm doing. I'm gonna just hit the carousel first. This is the mode that I'm gonna want to check out. So okay, so it's randomly the back button. Alright, I give it this, this music is really fucking cool. Alright, so I'm not gonna mess with Basic because my programming skills are about 20 years out of date. I mean, though, to be fair, that's still 20 years ahead of this thing, but, what game should I try out first? Breakdance? That's the name of a game? Okay, I know California Games. There's a shooter on here. I want to play a shooter. Ooh, what's that? Oh, that's cool. I'm curious how much I need to use this keyboard, too, versus a joystick. Like, I can use a joystick. Though I'm not good with these. Firelord, Gateway. Alright. Let's start with... Ooh, Impossible Mission? I know that game's supposed to be good, but, like, I feel like I'm gonna be... Alright. Here's a shooter. Firebird. What else we got? Jumpman. Sounds like Mario. Mega Apocalypse. Some of these have some pretty good graphics. Like, I guess this sucker lasted for a while. This was 1988 that Netherworld came out. Alright. This is after post-NES. I feel like I have to play a 1982 game, but I just don't want to. Play breakdance? Alright. Well, a request has been made. You will not understand Classic. It is Basic. Yeah. I mean, I have... Back in high school, I took Basic. Like, I knew it at one point. But yeah, current modern me? No, I'm not going to remember. Alright. Breakdance was the request. I can change music. A, I think, is the button to start. Big button. For some reason, it was the big button right there. Repeat Hotfeet's moves. Don't make a mistake, or you'll whack out. Alright, we're just going to start with Hotfeet Dance Contest. I think that's fair. Which button is it? Nope. Okay, wait. Big button. Oh, there's actually two-player games? What? This joystick is sick. That those clicks are awesome. Alright. F1 to start the game. I should hit F3 to practice. Shit. He didn't do anything! I was supposed to copy him. Okay. Oh, he did. Nope. What? How do I spin? Oh, okay, okay. Hold on. Let me, I think that was the same thing. Tess, I'm really bad at whacking out. Alright, I'm gonna try this again. So you use these two buttons and this. F1 to start game, F3 to practice. Okay, we're gonna F3. Alright, so what all buttons do things? Oh, okay, so that's left. That's up. Ooh, so right and left. Alright. Both of those just spin. Okay, I gotta stop pressing that button. These other buttons do anything? Oh, shit. So this is just Simon Says. I have to remember this, though. Mr. Hawks, you picked this, so this is what's gotta happen now. Nobody breakdanced to this music. It was that one? Shit! Yes, oh, I was right, okay. I had to remember the look of it. Oh man, I did it. I didn't look at what he did right there, so I'm fucked. Damn it. All right. Hold on. Okay. Take me back to the... One of you buttons has to take me back, right? There's 400 buttons on this thing, and I don't know which one takes me out of a thing. I can whack out, I get that. Alright. I can do this, but like, you can't just go back to the main menu? I feel like that's wrong. Alright. But, oh, hey, these have, like, a thin layer of plastic on them, too. What? I'm gonna leave that on. I don't want to get my greasy-ass fingers to ruin it. Okay. I tried breakdance. I gotta try something else. Boulder Dash. This is supposed to be good, right? Action puzzle game. New exciting versions are available. You can just go download new versions for this. This thing's actually pretty cool with the stuff you're able to do with it, so... Alright, I might go play Boulder Dash. I do want to go play one of those shooters I ran across. Cybernoia? I can't tell. Is that a shooter? It looks like a shooter. Yeah.
I just had to see this thing in person.
It's here. Big, right? Like,
awesome.
It's a little insane. It's, the games, though, they actually go up to, like, 1988 was the newest one I saw. So, this thing lasted for quite a while. It's not just old. It actually did compete. competes is maybe the wrong word, but it got games that like NES got, like Impossible Missions on the NES. So I like that so far I don't have to use this, but it's just so ridiculous that it has a functioning keyboard. Nobby the Aardvark.
Oh.
1992 Whoa. By Genesis. Oh my gosh. Genesis software.
Sounds amazing.
My brain went 1982 Genesis, I went to like Sega Genesis. Yeah, Mr. Ox, there you go. 1992. That's so surprising.
Hi.
Hi everyone.
Hi.
Tess says hi.
I don't know
everybody's name. I know who Lord of All Creation is for sure. And Mr. Hawk sounds familiar. I think I might know who it is. I need to get a list of, like, everybody. Oh, there was a new game, though, I thought, that was something brand new for this. Oh, I'm gonna have fun with this.
Retro keyboard awesomeness
there? Yeah. I'm gonna have fun. Street Sports Baseball. Street Sports Basketball. Street Sports Soccer. Alright. I thought there was like a new thing. That's kind of cool that they just have a Hall of Fame on here built in. Iridium 1986. That looks cool. Winter Games? I will not be good at that, I promise. Alright, well, let me, what was the first shooter I saw? Fire Lord? Oh, I guess Cybernoia. Let's try Cybernoia. I think it's Cybernoia. Oh! You just keep floating down. This is actually hard. Okay. Press return to end. That was really bad. Enter my initials. Oh, I can just type them. That's cool. Okay. How about backspace? Well, that annoys me that I can't backspace on a control. Oh, wait. Maybe? Hold on. Haha, delete key! I hit the little arrow thing, looks like a backspace. Dang. There, my terrible little score. Oh, that's rough. That was really rough. Okay. Alright. I know there's a better shooter on here than that. Something more my speed. Oh no, Fire Lord wasn't a shooter. Heartland. Oh, I still have competing music in the background with Spotify. I'm sorry about that. I just caught that. Alright. I wanted to try Impossible Mission. I should own this on NES, and I don't.
Another visitor. Stay a while. Stay forever.
Oh, what? Okay. I don't hold joysticks right, like... Oh, nope, I can't. I thought I could, like... Can I crouch? Nope, I just have to... Oh, wait, I maybe could just press down. Nope, down. Alright. My goal of jumping over this thing is not working. Every button is a jump. That can't be right.
Another visitor. Stay a while. Stay forever.
Why did I... Reset lifting platforms in this room. Temporarily disable robots in this room. That. Password required. Makes sense. I'm guessing the robots are bad. Go down more. Well, nothing here. Ah. Fine. Ugh. Yeah, I'm not super great at this. Okay. Let's see if I can go farther than that other one. Reset lifting platforms. Okay. Shit. I think I can jump over that thing, though. Alright. I see what I'm trying to do. I just need to actually do it. Nope. That ain't right. Oh, shit! Nothing there after all that? And I'm not gonna make that jump. Oh. Alright, that was good. That was good. Okay. So I obviously need to have these go down. Can I jump over you? No, man, if just turning around, I go very far. Oh, and jumping goes whatever direction I'm facing, no matter what. Okay. So I think I could jump over the robot and land on the other side. I think I just need to get... like this. Oh, shit! I mean, it kind of worked. It did kind of work. Go through these from the start. Oh, okay, I turned around. Not really sure what I was going for there. I got over him. Okay. Fuck. I gotta go reset these. Hold on. Why is the password required for that? If I just leave the room and come back, it'd be fixed. Yeah, okay, actually, that's... Oh, maybe not. Did it actually store that? Fuck. Yeah, that jump really screwed me. Oh, guess I gotta go find a password. Nope. Shit. Alright, this game's actually a little more interesting than that. What the fuck was that? Was that a map? What's in the fridge? Nothing. Okay. Ooh, another elevator. Ha! Nope, just get into the room the other way. That's the play right there. Damn it. Okay, so these terminals are worthless unless I have a password. Is that like a map? What is that? Oh. I want candy. Ah, motherfucker. Those things fly at you fast. Motherfucker. Okay, alright. I've played this game long enough. Let's go check out some other ones. What else we got? Alright, this looks like a proper shooter. Let me try that. Any requests on this, the whole game library is up on their website, so I'm cool with playing anything upon request. I'm gonna try to plug in my flash drive in a little bit too. Oh shit. Alright, I need to do this with my joystick moving hand. Motherfucker! You cannot move enough for that. Yeah. Dying on the very first thing makes me really hate this game. Holy shit, am I bad at this? Alright, no, I have to make it past the first round of bubbles. Fuck me. Alright, I am bad at that game. I'm very bad at that game. Alright, Jumpman. They liked it enough to make a second one, so maybe it's good. Gemini Wing, I thought you said the ROM didn't work. And overall, it seems like I can use the joystick for everything. What the fuck is happening? Oh, he's just making the start of the game. Let's use beginner, because that's gonna just go bad. Joystick or no? Oh! So, don't get those things? Or get them and then run? I just happened to get hit by something. That's all it was. Nothing. What? Nothing happened. I just fell to my death. All don't know. Alright. A lot of fun to my death right there. No! Get off the ladder. Oh, that's just a pit on the side. Okay, well, that sucked. Alright. Mother, get off the stupid ladder. No! It changed directions! Fuck that! Alright, there was some jump, man. Alright, that looks neat. I thought that was a cool side-scroller looking game. You are Monty. Huh. Oh yeah, yeah. 1992. Gotta try Nobby the Aardvark. So far I have not had to use the keyboard for like anything. Which, I mean, good for me, because I'd much rather prefer to use the joystick, but yeah, this camera is sort of not really having to do much, because this is just staying here. I do dig the functioning keyboard. I like the little save. You can't see it behind my banners, but there's a little blinking 3.5, 5 save icon. Push start button. We'll weigh in on which one that one is. America 1951 AD. You can't just... okay. I have a lot of lives that don't... Okay, I have to actually land on that fast-ass thing. And you don't have a jump button, you have to press up with the joystick while doing it. I'm just gonna waste all my lives right here. Everything kills me! Oh my god, you just die like if you walk near the water. I'm too spoiled by modern games. Oh, that's just all water, yeah, so I just can't go that way outright. Well, I landed on it. I guess that's a plus. I'll wait until it's, there we go. I'm glad that I just die. Oh, I thought it was coming sooner than that. Nope. This actually isn't that bad, like, you just have to be really precise. Oh. Damn it! I didn't know that was gonna happen. I mean, obviously. Nope, fuck you, birds. I have no attack. I'm literally just an aardvark, and the birds just kill me. I'm gonna say this is not great. Everything kills you. Okay. I gave Nobby a chance. I don't think I'll ever play that one again willingly. Nodes of Yasod. I like that it tells you what type of game it is. It's kind of a cool little thing. Isn't Paradroid the, like, not released game? I feel like that's Paradroid. Maze. Puzzle. Alright, this looks kind of neat. I guess we want to try it. few of these games I want to give a shot to. Alright, Speedball got a sequel. So obviously somebody liked it enough to make it again. So let's see how this one works. Also, Jumpman had like no good music to it. That was terrible. Sprinkler knockout, sure. Team Lakata. Fire to player F3 for main menu. I'm the green guy. Well, I scored. I kind of figured it out. You just gotta stand in the way of the ball a whole bunch. I don't know how to switch players, though. It's just whichever green guy is on the field. Didn't mean to do that. Oh! Angles are really accurate on that. That was pretty cool. Just gonna grab the ball and run it. Damn it! Damn it! Oh, shit. These micro switches in this joystick are awesome. I need to redo like my switches on my arcade cabinet, but I don't know how to do that shit. It's a lot of work. Oh shit! Shit! No! Don't score right off the. Ah, I got it. Oh, that was an own goal. All right, halfway through the game. Halfway through the game. What? What just happened? Ah, shit. That was a good shot, too. No! It's tied. I juked him. I juked him good. No, no! No! Bullshit! I don't know what that power-up was, but what? That was a good shot, too. That one, I think, actually made it. That's bullshit. Nope. No! Oof. Oh, well, I thought I had a teammate there. Alright. Bribe official. I mean, obviously... Alright. What the hell is this called? I already forgot. Sports ball? It's sports ball. Speedball? Speedball. Alright, I gotta try out at least one more game on here before I start messing around with all my random ROMs. I kinda wanna try the adventure game, that Sword of Fargol. Author and composer, one dude. That's really cool. I want this one though because of the stupid little astronaut. Platforming is really atrocious on this, so I definitely don't want to try platformers. Well, that looks fun. Alright, let me see if I can find a shooter that actually is kind of fun, because that other one I did not like. Alright, we'll try Zynaps. You gotta love that these old games were designed by like three people in a basement. Modern games are billions of dollars. Oh. Minus that I crashed myself, that was better. That looked like it was a power-up. Are those bad? Okay, don't attack those bad things. Oh no, this is a good thing. I think I hit something else then. Alright. That was rough. What is that? Okay. My ROMs are all on this flash drive, I think. I'm just gonna plug this in. Oh, it's a USB stick, so, you know, it's upside down the first four times. Alright, it's not bad. I do feel like the plastic on this thing is a little cheaper than I would have liked, but not too upset about it. C64 games. Alright, so I have to go try Gemini Wing, see if I can get this ROM to work. And then apparently not. Or I have to run this elsewhere. Because that didn't work well at all. What is that? Nope. Alright. Somebody has requested that I play Kennedy Approach. Ready, run. Is there a run button? Run. Ooh, okay, there we go. So right off the bat, I'm an air traffic controller, so this game's going to be really exciting. The fast-paced world of air traffic control. In 1985 graphics. Skill level 1 to 5, replay from disc and demo. I'm just going to go for 1. Yeah, we'll do Atlanta. Yeah, we'll start with Atlanta. I feel like I'm gonna use the keyboard more in this one too than the joystick. Whoa, okay. No, still can use the joystick, but alright, so there's a B. I see a plane. What do I want to do with it? ID A B C D Origin A B A A. So I just want this. I just want B.
Delta 801. Head 180 cleared for landing.
Okay.
Roger.
Did I just tell it to land there? No. Alright, so A, B, C, D. No? Just typing it all in, isn't it? A, C, D are awaiting takeoff. You have to type their letter to get them. Okay, well, I just typed A, so once I do it, how do I make it take off? Okay. C. origin destination. Yeah. Adjust the width of the joystick. Okay. Where is it going? Its destination is D, so its destination is Dallas, I guess. Okay, so B. All right, so that's already doing what I want it to do, right? It's going to turn head 180 and clear to land, right? So that one's doing what I want it to do.
Delta 801, head 1.
You have to leave the map at altitude 4.
Landing. Roger.
All right, so let's just start with A. A wants to originate from Atlanta. It wants to go to Chicago. So and then how do I get it to take off?
American 700.
Oh, okay.
Turn left to 315. Climb to 2,000 feet.
Oh, I think I had B. B took off a little further than I wanted to. Okay, so B, I need you to go. How do I get B to turn around? Oh, I changed its altitude.
Delta 801, turn left.
Why is A going the other direction? Oh, I think it's that's why.
2,000 feet.
F.
Roger.
F's trying to go where? To 5? Which one's 5? I don't know what that is. Oh, it's going to go to B. Okay. F can just go straight. B's going to crash into F. A's going the wrong direction. Not very good at this. Well, I pressed A. Get me on the A one. Why is B going that way? Okay, F, I want you to keep going that way, so.
United 205.
Oh!
Turn left to 000 at 5,000 feet.
B.
Roger.
I didn't want F to turn. Yeah, I get that I have to turn B. It's that none of them want to do what I want them to do. Okay. So the arrows turn left at 270 at 270 east. Okay.
American 700, turn left.
Okay. Well, I didn't want that to do it.
2,000 feet.
Head 315. F is just circling in a pattern.
Delta 801. Head 315 at 2,000 feet.
Okay.
United 205, turn right.
Alright, A is going the direction I want it to now, for the most part.
Feet. Roger. American 700,
okay.
Turn left to 3.
H is trying to go into Atlanta.
Roger.
F, why are you, where is F going?
United 205.
It takes time for them to turn.
000 at 5,000 feet.
Why is A going south now? I get it matters which way you turn, but like, if I'm telling them to go a certain direction. Okay, let's focus on B since B was the problem child. I would need B to turn left. Like, if I turn it this way,
Delta
B should go diagonally down.
Turn left to 225 at 2,000.
Or am I turning
feet.
It around too much and it's going down? Is that the problem? F is going the direction I want it to now, so F's actually doing what I want. So I want F to go.
United 205, turn right
H is doing what I want it to do.
5,000 feet. Roger.
Okay. Yeah, and I can tell which way they're going because the graphics on the airplanes are so detailed. H is doing what I want. B is almost doing what I want. Can I adjust their... I can't adjust their speed, just their alter... When they get to Atlanta, if that's where they're trying to go, then do I have to lower their descent at all? I suppose that would make sense.
Delta 801, head 225, descend Delta 407, head 270.
Oh, I definitely crashed like several of these.
Roger.
I'm sure that's not a good sound. I know they are, but... Okay, H. I guess
American
there's a conflict,
seven,
but let
zero,
me...
Zero, head 315, clock
there.
Four,
H is
zero,
higher.
Seven,
oh, A
two,
is going
to
collapse.
Seven, zero,
I think that's...
Climb to 2,000 feet.
A, go
Roger.
Up.
American 700, head 315... Climb to 3,000 feet.
They're not gonna collide. They're at least 1,000 feet apart. F is almost there. Zero to land, four to leave the map. Okay, so B needs to go down.
This is Delta 801 emergency. 8 minutes fuel.
Yeah, I get that you have no fuel. Land
United
there.
205. Head 045.
F, I need you to turn.
Roger.
So I need F to lower its speed and I need to turn.
United 205. Turn left to 000. Descend to 1,000 feet. Roger.
H.
Delta 407. Head 270. Cleared for landing.
Roger.
B. Delta 801. Turn left to 045 at 1,000 United 205.
Okay, so they turn every...
To 315 at
2,000
feet.
I'm gonna get F down.
Feet.
I think I got F where
Roger.
F used to be. And H didn't land. I thought it was gonna land. Okay, F just... B is going to crash. I don't care about B anymore. I give up on B.
United 205, turn right to 000 at 2,000 feet. Roger.
Okay, F, you should be getting there.
United 205, turn left. 315 cleared for landing. Roger. American 700, turn left to 270 at 3,000 feet. Roger. American 700, head.
So they have to go off the board.
Cleared for landing.
They have to be on the white line of dots.
Roger.
So F is wrong. It left right next to where it's supposed to go. I thought B was supposed to go to Atlanta. B's origin was B. And it's landing at A. Well, A is leaving the board too. Alright. Okay, so most of these suck. B, I need you to head here.
Delta 801.
Where's H going?
To 3-1. This is Delta 801.
When their destination is A, I assume that's I assume that destination A is Atlanta, right? Like, an I don't have yet. B's just gonna crash. Okay. So K, I'm gonna turn you a bit. 9 1 0 K right.
Turn right to 225.
I'm not worried about H, I'm not worried about B, because I already can't figure those two out. Roger. L, it originated from Miami and it's also going to Atlanta. 3 bad exits. Yeah. 23 minutes of flight delays. I don't know about continue career. Restart entire game. Alright, I'm gonna try this again. I'm gonna do Dallas Fort Worth though. I'm at least gonna try something else. This game has no music either. Oh, there's way more shit going on. I don't like this. I shouldn't have picked that. Okay, so D is originally coming from B, and it's trying to get to F. F is Dallas-Fort Worth right there in the center. Oh, that's why. There's two. I get it. Okay, so you don't. All right, so I kind of wanted that to just keep going. So what about A? Where are you? A, your destination is E. So you're going to do that, and you can take off now. Or did I not do that? Because you're not.
Delta 700.
Okay, I got A on the board.
225. Climb to 2,000 feet.
B. Roger. Is leaving from Dallas. Destination also Dallas? What? That don't make any sense. Alright, I'm not going to worry about B yet. Give me C. C's destination is Chicago. Okay, if I had him in the right direction to start, that helps. They turn at the next dot, right? Oh, I see. Yeah.
American 902, turn right to 045, climb to 4,000 feet. Roger.
Okay, so if I want D to turn at the next dot it collides with, I do
American
that, right?
303, turn right to 270 at 5,000 feet.
Give me A.
Roger.
No, give me A. Oh, I'm not pressing A, that would help.
Delta 700.
Ah, see, you're going the wrong way entirely.
To 180 at 2,000 feet. Roger. American 902.
Oh, and CD I turned.
045.
Oh.
To 1,000 feet.
I want. All right, hold on. I think I'm figuring this out. I don't know why in the world you find this fun.
American.
This worries me so much about you. Okay, so D, I need it to turn right.
Roger.
I just need to turn right once, and I need it to. Oh, it has to leave at 4,000. Okay, hold on. No. Go up to. Climb to 4,000.
Head 225. Climb to 4,000 feet. Roger.
I'll see if I can get A straightened out.
Turn right to 315. Descend to 1,000 feet. Roger.
Yeah, I know it was the wrong exit.
American 303. Turn left to 225 at 5,000 feet.
Roger. To get it to land, do I actually have to follow those arrows? I probably do, huh? Okay, so C, I need you to climb to 4,000. Let me make you a slight adjustment to
American
the right.
902, head 045, climb to 4,000 feet.
Okay, I can see that. It is challenging. I don't think it's fun, though. But. Alright, G, I need you to go to destination. Your destination is Dallas-Fort Worth, so I'm going to turn. I'm going to drop yours.
American 506, turn left.
And
to
D's destination is.
Descend to 4,000 feet. Roger.
And do you have to, you do have to aim them? Okay, so D, I'm gonna...
American 303.
D, I'm gonna loop around and see if I can get it right.
Descend to 2,000 feet.
C, I need you to turn slightly.
902, turn right to 090.
If I get one right, I'll call this a big win.
Roger.
There's no music or anything. Ugh. This game's just rough. This is what you do for a request. Oh.
American 902. Turn left to 045.
Turn left? I didn't say left.
Roger.
Okay, well, that's the end of that. Now it's going to go off the board. Okay, so D, I need you to turn left.
American 303, turn left to 135 at 2,000 feet.
Wrong exit altitude? It exited at 4,000. I thought that's what I was supposed to do. Okay. D, you're not turning left. There it goes. Okay. G, I need you to descend to... We'll descend to 1,000.
American 506, head 270, descend to 1,000 feet. Roger. American 506, head 270, cleared for landing. Roger.
So am I not landing this because it's still too high when it gets to those dots?
American 303.
Because G is just flying right past Dallas Fort Worth. Or Fort Worth, I should say.
2,000 feet. Roger.
Oh, dude, I'm gonna die. This is so rough. I don't... Okay. So here, I'm obviously going to have to turn G around because it's all sorts of wrong.
American 506, turn right to 045, climb to 1,000 feet. Roger. American 303.
Okay, so I'm going to watch D really heavily here. So D, D's going
to
hit this dot
2,000 feet.
And it should adjust.
Roger.
Yeah, okay, so D hit the dot and it's turning. So G, I want it to do the same.
American 506.
So this is going to take it, it's going
to
turn here.
090 at 1,000 feet.
And then it's going to go to the next dot and it's going to turn again. What the fuck does K even want?
This is American 303.
Oh, you have no gas? Yeah, that's not a shock. Okay, so D, I want to turn you head turn. I want you to turn
American
left. D
303.
Okay.
Turn left.
If I get D or G in the right spot, I'll call it a win.
2,000 feet. Roger.
Okay. So D is gonna hit that dot, so I want to turn. Like that.
American 303.
So it's gonna hit this dot
turn
and it's gonna turn
to 315 at 2,000 feet. Roger.
Okay, and now I need D to turn again and reduce their height.
American 303. Turn left to 270. Descend to 1,000 feet. Roger.
Descending their height moves their dots, I swear. So now I'm going to fly under it because it...
American 303. Head 270 cleared for landing.
Okay, see, but now G's on the wrong dotted line. So you have to put him, like, a line above it.
American 303.
Yeah, because look, it's too, isn't that too low?
270 cleared for landing. Roger.
Okay, so I need you to do a hard... Oh, actually, wait.
American 506, turn right to 225 at 1,000 feet.
Oh, I so don't care if you do crash.
Roger.
And K's been here for a while. K, let me select the damn thing. Oh, ha! I'm pressing the K on my computer, not the Commodore.
American 710. Turn right to 225 at 5,000 feet. Roger. American 710. Head 225. Descend to 3,000 feet. Roger. This is American 303.
I need...
Emergency. 6 minutes fuel.
Yeah, because you should have fucking landed, but because of the way dots work, you didn't.
American 506, turn right.
Why are they still in a conflict?
70 at 1,000 feet. Roger.
Oh my god. Okay.
This is American 506, emergency. 8 minutes. American 710.
After pushing my other keyboard. I tapped on the wrong keyboard too many times.
To 2,000 feet. Roger. American 506, turn right. 270 at 1,000 feet. Roger.
Oh my god. That game's horrible. That's so frustrating. Alright. I'm gonna try something that might be fun. Boulder Dash. Okay. Ugh! Like, how do you play that? There's no music. Yep, I should have seen that coming. Okay, I kind of get the gist of this game. But the boulders do actually roll and move. This is actually kind of fun. No music, but I'm not just changing the directions of airplanes. I tried Candy Approach. I tried. Thank you. damn it. The second I did it, I saw that. Too late. I saw it too late. Mm-hmm. Ugh. Alright, so Boulder Dash I can at least sort of play. Oh, man. I'm gonna be mad about Candy Perch for a while. Okay. There, I'll save state on that one, because that one's actually one I did okay-ish on. Okay, there it is. Alright. Curious why it was actually not popping up. Alright, what other games did we download that oh, shit. Ah, no! No! I don't want to play Kennedy Approach again. It's painful. Exit. I'm back. Nope. How do I go up a folder? Oh, okay, there we go. Maybe Gemini Wing did work, because it actually did look like it might have. It had the run option. That looks corrupt. Whatever that is. Something's corrupt. Oh, I can be wrong. I'm just not wrong about this. Alright, so space to read, run stop to start. Run stop. Enable or disable fast loader. Enable. High score saver or trainer game. High score. Load reset high scores. Load. And then is this it? Is this where it was causing the problem for you? Yeah, that doesn't seem like it's doing anything at all. That's a bummer. Okay. Up a folder. Okay. Let's try Zork. Never played a Zork. I'm sure I'm not going to last too long in this either. Come on, at least have some music. Isn't this just text-based? How long does it take to load? I'm so spoiled by modern games. Or is this just it and is it broke? Run. Actually, don't know if I'll hate it or not. I just need it to get into it so I can actually try. I'm just impatient. Like, why hasn't it loaded already? What could it be possibly loading? You gonna load ever? What are you doing? Okay. I'm gonna try that again and see if it'll actually load this time. I won't press anything. Maybe I pressed too many things. I assume yes was the right answer. We're gonna press no this time? Okay, okay. Alright. West of house, you were standing in open field west of a white house with a boarded front door. There's a small mailbox here. Open it. Open mail. Oh, it's probably open mailbox. Opening the small mailbox reveals a leaflet. Read leaflet. Okay. This is not quite a normal keyboard. Oh, well, yeah, obviously you don't, because I can't spell. Leaflet. Oh, yeah. I didn't add a space. Read leaflet. Zork is a game of adventure, danger, and low cunning. That's good, because I don't have high cunning. This is not a stat I was granted upon birth. In it, you'll explore some of the most amazing territory ever seen by mortals. No computer should be without one. Okay. Yeah, well, okay, what do I do? So I read the leaflet. Can I scroll back up to things that happened? Nope, that's not going to make it happy. Because that would be worthwhile to be able to do. Scroll. Alright, open door. Because there was a door. The door cannot be opened. Open window. Search. What do you want to search? Search house. You find nothing unusual. And now I'm lost. So, if I could, can you? You have to be able to scroll back up with something. There's no D-pad. There's any of these search. Nope. Obviously, that's not going to be it. I can't go up with this. West of house. Okay. If I can't go back up. Wait. Okay, so I missed something. Okay. You are standing in open field west of a white house with a boarded front door. There's a small mailbox here. Search field? Okay. I searched the mailbox. Not sure. It's here. I'm at the house. Okay. Break door. Find tool. break door with mailbox. Go to back of house. Look for back door. For window. Can't see any window here. I already tried that. Cellar. Basement door? Okay. Alright, so I'm in a field by a house. I looked in a mailbox. I can't open the door to the house. Search mailbox. Okay. Nah, shit. You can't go that way. I can't just leave, okay? Here, I'll kill that second webcam for a sec. There, at least so you can see where I'm typing. Enter yard? Backyard? Probably doesn't know what the word backyard means. Try W? What is W? Do I need a key? Like, why W? What happened? How did W get me there? That is interesting. Okay, this is a forest with trees in all directions. East there appears to be sunlight. You hear in the distance the chirping of a songbird. I'm just going to always type search. You find nothing unusual. Okay, east. In past winding through a dimly lit forest, the path heads north-south here. One particularly large tree. Search tree. Alright, I'm going to stop giving up on searching. You are clearing with a forest around you on all sides. A path leads south. On the ground is a pile of leaves. Search pile. I'm just going to always search. So we'll go south. Forest path. North of house. You're facing the north side of a white house. There's no door here, and all the windows are boarded up. To the north, a narrow path winds through the trees. Let's go east. You're behind the house. Slightly ajar open window. Alright, I have to put on music, though, because holy shit. Just anything while I'm doing this. Move pile? Oh, well, I have to go back to the pile now. Can I just type return to pile? Okay, I can get into the window behind the house. So how did I get there? I went east, so I'm going to go west, north. Oh, I'm in the house now. Okay. Well, all right, I'm not going back to that pile. Table seems to have been used recently for the preparation of food. Passage leads to the west, and a dark staircase can be seen leaning upward. A dark chimney leads down, and to the east is a small window which is open. Bottles. Take bottle. So, a passage leads to the west, and a dark staircase can be seen leaning upward. Oh, can't. Okay. There we go. Eventually, one way. Living room. There is a doorway to the east. A wooden door with strange gothic lettering to the west. A trophy is. Take sword. Take lantern. Alright, so I have a lantern, sword, and bottle. Hey, Kez, what's up? We're gonna see if we can go look at that door a bit more. Okay, it's. Break door. Sword. Alright, oh well. I'm back in the kitchen. Damn it. Alright. West living room. Alright, so I'm back outside. South of house. Behind house. Search sack. The thing's really cool. I'm messing with Zork, and I'm really not super good at it. There's a lot going on. Move rug. All right, let me go back to the living room. Move rug. I'm glad you're old and remember this. You also played this recently, right? Okay. Open door. Oh, well, okay. Yeah, I didn't hit space. I had to put on music though because this game has no music. Okay. Open trapdoor. I'll give it some credit. The text-based adventure is actually not entirely dumb. It kind of does know what I'm doing. Go downstairs. Oh, so now I'm locked in here. But my sword's growing faint blue. So did they just rip this off from The Hobbit? Is there an orc down here? I'm likely to be eaten by a Gru. Look around. Pitch black, you're likely... It's not gonna let me break anything with the sword. Nice try. Okay. Yeah. Well, when I don't type right. You can't do that. Okay. Go upstairs. The trap door is closed. I tried to break it. It said nice try. Okay, it's pitch black. I'm likely to be eaten by a Gru. I can't turn on the lantern. I didn't have batteries. It said it needed batteries. Fine. In a dark and damp cellar with a narrow passageway leading north and a crawlway to the south. On the west is the bottom of a steep metal ramp, which is unclimbable. Okay, so let's go through the crawl. Well, no, let's go north. Let's go north. The troll room? There's a troll? Oh, man. Mm. I removed its head! Almost as soon as the troll breathes its last breath, a cloud of sinister black fog envelops him. When the fog lifts, the carcass has disappeared. Your sword is no longer glowing. Huzzah! Search corpse. Search body? Search troll? Well, I'm still in a room! What do you mean? Okay. I'll just try to go more north. Okay? So I literally killed a troll for no reason? Oh, yeah, okay. Take axe. Okay, now go south. East of chasm. East edge of a chasm, the bottom which cannot be seen, a narrow passage goes north, and the path you are on continues to the east. So do I go north or east? Or do I just dive into the chasm? No. I'm not that bad of a mood. Okay. We're gonna go north. Oh, shit. North goes back into the cellar. Okay, so south. South again? Can't go that way. So I... Path you're on continues east. Oh, I think I all right. This is an art gallery. Most of the paintings have been stolen by vandals with exceptional taste. Vandals left through either the north or west exits. There's still one chance for you to be a vandal, for one on the far wall is a painting of unparalleled beauty. Should I take the painting? Should I look at the painting? Oh, so wait, if I do this... Ah, okay. I'm not gonna take the painting. I'm not a monster. South end of the room is an open door, also covered with paint. Take paper, read paper. All right. Anything else in here? Look. So let's go north then? South end of the room is an open door. Yeah, we'll go south. Oh, I'm back in the gallery. Okay, look around the gallery. Yeah, fuck it. I'm gonna take the painting. Take painting. Drop painting. Drop painting. Don't have the painting. Okay, well then, don't worry about it. Oh. So L just looks. I don't even have to type L. Or look. Okay. North and west. I didn't go west. Okay, what's west? East of... Oh, that's where I got in here. Shit. South. Back in the gallery. Look. So I came in from the west, so I got to go north into the studio. Look. Narrow chimney leads up. I'm going to climb the chimney. I might get stuck, so it might be interesting. I don't want to drop my weapons. Is there a way I can check what I'm carrying? Like, ah, okay, yeah, inventory, aye, sweet. A glass ball contains... Okay. I have a Zork owner's manual. But if I go south, that's just where I was. And there was no other exit, so I have to go up the chimney. Damn it! I have to go up the chimney. Drop axe? Climb chimney? Type chimney right? Take axe. Drop sword. Try to climb the chimney now that I dropped both my cool weapons. What the? Okay. Drop lantern? So now I have no lantern, no sword, no axe. And I can't add spaces. What the fuck else do I have still? Is it the bottle? Okay, well, whatever. Take axe. I'm picking up all my stuff then. Fuck this. Okay. Someone carrying a large bag is casually leaning against one of the walls here. He does not speak, but it's clear from his aspect that the bag will be taken only over his dead body. Okay. Take bag. Make dead body. Talk? I should reread the manual, that's fair. Kill thief. Sword. I have died. I have died in Zork. Alright, that's actually kind of neat. I think I would need a brief little pile of descriptions, like what all the buttons do, because there's actually a lot. I'm sure there's commands I didn't see or know. So... Okay, what other games are on this that I grabbed? Grab Ultima. Okay. Hold up. Let's see if this works. Let's see how good Batman is on the C64. so many of these, I need to know what buttons do what. Spacebar. Spacebar was my key there. Like, I didn't know that. That was some music, too. Unlimited life. Sure, why not? Motherfucker. Alright. I'll kill my music again so we can actually hear the beauty of the Commodore 64 music. Alright, what else is on this pile? 4-2. It had a lot of games that weren't on there, so. I just feel like there was a couple other ones I wanted to try. They're supposed to be good games for this system. IK Plus? That sounds familiar. I remember looking up a list. So this is, I got these, man. Somebody had a website of old Commodore 64 ROMs, and the thing runs ROMs. Like, it just does it. So. I don't have to, it's not modded or anything like that. I literally plugged in a flash drive and read it immediately. It's really cool. All right, let's get through this. Get me in. All right. Space to read, run, stop, start. Is this a fighting game? No! Another dead ROM. Boo. Fine, I won't play that, I guess. Ninja. A ninja game, huh? Double drive game. This joystick is really, really good. Well made. No. Alright, hold on. I'm gonna... I think it's freaking out... When I hit the space bar, I think it's trying to... I don't know. I feel like something's wrong with a lot of those ROMs. Alright, I'll keep looking really quick just in case there's anything I really, really want to try on here. Maniac Mansion. Wow. But given that these have been all buggy messes, that's a shame, too. Oh, see, it's too many games. Let me see if Prince of Persia works. I keep messing around with some of these ones. Normal reset. Oh. Run. What the fuck? Okay. So I guess I didn't want to do that. I wanted to load games. Even though I don't have a save file? Oh, I guess load in the old context would have meant just like load. Where's the control button? Control L. Or not. Infinite everything. Why not. The ROM doesn't work super well because all sorts of weird, like, dumb things like that are happening. Alright, I'll stop messing around with the ROMs. I wanted to try Paradroid that was on here. Oh, yeah, I want to try Monty. We'll try Monty. I gotta give. There's gotta be a platformer on here. I didn't catch that. Oh, shit. That was really hard to time. I'm gonna argue with that a bit. Yeah, that's fun. I did slightly better, I guess? God damn. I didn't enjoy Monty. Sorry, Monty. What about another world? This looks kind of neat. I can try every game on here. So the fact that it can run ROMs is really cool. Oh. Oh shit. Yeah, I don't know where to go either. No, damn it. I'm not really sure what I'm trying to do here. Man, early games. Like, what are you trying to do? I'm like, I don't fucking know. Okay. That's weird. Not really my cup of tea. This game sucked. I hated it. Oh yeah, I want to try this one where I'm a little astronaut. This looked cool. Please don't disappoint me. I can pick the keyboard if I want. Why does every game that jumps in this platform like have? Have the flip jump. Oh. I guess I wanted to go down one of those pits. So for now I'm like stuck. Fish really fucked me up, okay. You motherfucking fish! And I died? Shit. Gotta avoid those fish like the fucking plague. Okay. Everything else. Well, I don't know what that little thing is with the dick nose, but. Alright, do you bump me if I'm just on here? Okay. I'm gonna try to get back up. I got some good height on my jumps. No! No! No, and I'm dead. Oh, wait. It bounced me up? Well. Thank you. taking a breather right there? You can't jump because you jumped out right there. 90% complete. Okay. Alright. That's a thing. That's a thing for sure. Not sure how I feel about it. Sure what I'm actually trying to do, though. I can be honest, I don't really enjoy that either. Okay, here. Let's see if I find our keyboard game. Oh, hey, I wanted to try Pit Stop. That'd be fun. Sure. I like the driver too, still shows up on the screen, even though it's a PC. I can't really control. Okay. This is why racing games invented putting in music. Every time I bump somebody, the speed just plummets. Get out of my lane! Oh, shit. Oh, I lose terribly. I can appreciate this from the age of it point of view, but like, that's a cool way they did the sound effect too, but he drifted out of his way to fuck me up. so far behind him. Oh, I can go faster than I was. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can do better in lap two. No! He literally pulled over to get in my way. Nope, see? I'm still not gonna catch up with him. How bad is my time, I guess. See, I tell you, they swear they pull over to get me. Oh my god, that noise, that kills me. This is a shoot 'em up where you're a frog? Alright, you got me. I'm curious what this is. You have no... It's not... How is this shooting up? Everything seems to kill me. That's there. Oh, if there's an enemy, it could shoot, I guess? Nope. Nothing shoots. No music. Talk some shit on that game. Robin of the Wood. Maybe. Oh yeah, I want to try this one. This one looked kind of neat. Weird puzzle game. Human players, computer players, zero. Five chips in a row. I'm just going to start with five chips in a row. I feel like those get progressively worse. I I just had to get five. I literally just had to get five chips in a row. Okay. Wait. No, how do I back? Okay, hold on. I want to hit. There we go. Okay. Let's make you one. Can I increase that? Okay. Black holes. Let me. Okay, again, the lack of music. Whoever invented video game music needs a medal. Human players one. Computer players three. Let's get some. We're gonna go to six. Or we do seven. No, shit. Get off mine. Oh, you got it right there. That's kind of awkward. That's a little neat. Black hole just appeared on me, motherfucker. Alright, at least with more things, it's a little more fun. Alright. Speedball is kind of cool. I'll give it Speedball a little bit of credit. Not a great name. Speedball is probably not a great name. Sort of Fargle. Sort of Fargle. It's not great. I love that they put in a working keyboard for this. Like, it's not necessary for a lot of games. But still, it's cool. Wait. Okay. I'll wait. I'm not patient. What am I waiting for? I can enter a whole bunch. Okay, I feel like I did something syntax error. Yeah, that's... Okay. I'm gonna try starting that game again without pressing buttons. We'll see what happens. Cool. Okay. It says wait. I'll actually wait this time. Experience 0, experience level 1, maximum hits 12. It says wait down behind the bottom left picture. I have one healing potion. Okay, cool, cool, cool. One teleport spell. Your quest begins. Okay, some rough load times, all things considered. Okay. That's supposed to be foreboding music. Oh, it's like a wolf thing. Oh, a hobgoblin. I just stood. You have killed a hobgoblin. You died. All right. What else we got on here? I'm gonna try this. See what this, how this one works. All right. You can't jump, so you really have to hit those. Felt like I couldn't jump. Oh, it's a timer? Right. Or lives? Yep, I knew I was coming too. Basic. I could do a hello world I haven't done that in a while. So we tried breakdance. What else we want to give a good run through before we a puzzle game confusion. Okay, let's see how this works. I'm cool with it. Okay. Oh. Okay, so I need to get that. Okay. Seems like the easiest thing is just time it right with catching it. Oh. I'm guessing that's a bad bomb in the middle. Oh, did I just nail it? That was quick. Okay. I nailed that kind of on accident, but I did. Why was there a music on off button if there's no music? Shit. I fucked that up. Have to get you going again. Oh, it's the timer, that's why. Okay. Fuck. I see why this gets challenging-ish. Oh, shit! Ah, yeah, okay, that gets rough. Alright. Well, that was just not great. Do I have a gun? If this one has a gun in it, that'd be pretty good. Cyberdyne Warrior, get ready. Oh! Getting burned like a shitload. Oh shit. Okay. Minus I'm not very good at it. Ah, no, okay. I'm gonna chill on this for a second. Alright, so. We're gonna stare at here for 1 second. So the Commodore 64, the Mini, which is not Mini, this is the size of my freaking shoulder blades, functioning keyboard, overall really nice joystick, I think that's nice. The keyboard itself is a cool size, I like the color on it. Plastic feels a little under what kind of quality I like on the plastic. It's ran great. It didn't run some of the ROMs I plugged in, but, you know, that could happen, right? Like, that could be bad ROMs. Of the games on it, I will say, like, offhand, I think the stupid Speedball was pretty fun, the little sports game. And Impossible Mission. Impossible Mission, I think, is really pretty cool. That's also on NES. Boulder Dash was a little fun, too. It was neat. I like this games carousel. I think, overall, this is a pretty cool system. Was it worth the money? Well, probably not. Probably not the smartest thing for me to buy. But, everyone's a Wally. See, I need to look up what some of these games are. So, either way, it's been pretty fun. I've had a nice little time messing with this thing. So, one last big camera look at this. In all its, you know, glory. Nice joystick, like I said. But yeah. So anyway, I'm gonna call it. I wanted to really just check this thing out for a little bit. I got about 2.5 hours of messing with it in. I really like unique things like this. I love this flashback to a different time for video gaming. And yeah, none of the games really like popped out to me. But I didn't play a lot of them. Like, that looks pretty cool. Like Heartland. I just bounced around and I played Candy Approach for way too long. I don't know why I listened to Mike. But thanks for checking this weird, stupid thing out. I dig it. I dig it. So anyway, I hope everyone has a wonderful evening. And I'm gonna call it. I'll talk to you all later.